What do you got for me? This the one? Good, this good to go. Come again.
We'll be right back. Thank you.
Kristen! I can't believe you've come! Tell me, do you know what's happening?
And I'll explain everything that had occurred. And you thought?
I see. So Ellen is here as well. It pains me to say that Chester is the one who locked me in here. He did so immediately after everyone in the castle began to transform. I spoke with him. I inquired as to his objective. And in brief, he actually told me. It seems he intends to use the castle's clock tower to release the energy of the statues. Count McGuire had it built several years ago, and I believe it functions as more than a simple timepiece. Theoretically, it interferes with the vein of spirits that runs beneath Felghana, redirecting its flow. If true, the Count may have used this device to harness the statue's powers from afar. Likely, his true goal was to track their locations so he could fully unleash their powers for his own deification. But Chester beat him to it and brought about the dark mist that hangs within these halls. It twists the minds of the people it touches, transforming them, changing them into bloodthirsty beasts. And sadly, those affected by this mist are lost to us forever. Adol, please, you must stop Chester. His desire for revenge may be justified, in as much as it can be. But in seeking this revenge, he has sinned most deeply. For me. This the one? Good to go. This the good to go. Come again.
Thank you.
What do you got for me? This the one? Good to go. Come again.
Welcome. That's the one. Thank you. Don't be a stranger.
Adol detailed everything that had occurred and returned Elena's pendant to her.
Oh. I really don't know how to thank you. I feel like I've done nothing but cause trouble for you ever since you arrived. You came all this way for me, and brought me my dearest possession, no less. Thank you, Adol. Chester finally told me everything. 12 years ago, our home was destroyed by monsters. He plans to get revenge on... I understand his feelings, but I don't agree with him. He shouldn't involve innocent people in his own selfish quest for vengeance. It'll make him no better than the Count himself. I tried to tell him that, but he just wouldn't listen to me. I don't think he believes he even can turn back at this point. Not after stabbing Dogi. But if he manages to carry out this whole scheme, then... he really won't be able to turn back. So please, Adol, stop him. Stop him from making the
biggest mistake. You're Adol, I assume? Elena told me all about you. I'm Bob, a miner's apprentice from Redmont. Yeah, I'm the guy everybody thinks is dead, apparently. Died when that bridge collapsed, according to Elena. In actuality, I've just been locked up in this dungeon the whole time. And I was just working like usual, minding my own business. and Chester and a bunch of soldiers came out of nowhere. I wasn't trying to eavesdrop, but I just so happened to overhear them discussing some of McGuire's plans. I knew I was in trouble, so I tried to hide. They found me, arrested me, locked me in here. I bet Grandma's worried sick.
Did you really beat that huge mechanical beast guarding the prison? You're unbelievable.
I got caught by Chester coming out of the clock tower when I was fleeing for dear life from all my zombie coworkers. I tried to get away from him, but I was so exhausted from running and so confused by what was going on. Come to think of it, what was Chester doing in the clock tower to begin with? I don't know if that's where you were planning on going, but if it is, it probably be this. Don't you worry about me. I intend to find myself an opening, take it, and get the hell out of here. Can't rush it or I'll be caught in here. Or killed. And until I do, this cell isn't any more dangerous than anyone else.
Here, so if you wouldn't mind, please don't disturb me right now.
Adol informed Ida that Bob was actually still alive.
What? Please, tell me you're not just toying with an old woman's emotions. Down in the castle dungeon, cut off from all outside contact. How awful. But he's alive. He's really alive, and Elena's with him? That's good. I'm glad there's someone there for him. I just hope they can both make it back to Redmont safely.